the challenge of climate change is a real one, and it becomes even more of a challenge the more greenhouse gas emissions we produce. And so capitalism has allowed, we have 7 billion people on the planet. Many in the United States have achieved the American dream. And in India and in China and in other nations, people living there are achieving the American dream of improved living standards. An unintended consequence of that is more and more greenhouse gas emissions, which makes the challenge of climate change even worse. But at the same time, cities and living in cities allow certain opportunities that makes it easier for us to adapt to climate change. So to say that again, farmers will face tougher climate change challenges than urbanites. And people who live in cities have certain opportunities to protect themselves from anticipated challenges. And so urbanization offers certain opportunities to protect ourselves from climate change. Capitalism is both friend and foe when it comes to climate change. So many liberal environmentalists, and I'm including myself, point to the Hummer and other pieces of the American dream as capitalist products. Some of suburban life has led to increased greenhouse gas emissions and has unintentionally exacerbated the challenge of climate change. But there's other markets, for example, markets for energy efficient appliances and markets for other low carbon products, whether it's solar panels or electric vehicles. And so the magic of the capitalism's invisible hand is as the challenge of climate change emerges, there's going to be an increased demand for solutions to the challenges we face. And so one of the themes of my Climatopolis book is that crisis and challenges actually creates new opportunities. And so in capitalism is a system of markets. When you want coffee in the morning, there might be someone willing to sell you that coffee. That climate change is going to pose new challenges for us, and that's going to create new opportunities for businessmen and businesswomen who can deliver solutions. If we expect that because of climate change that water prices might rise or that electricity prices might rise, so water prices rising because of drought, this creates incentives for entrepreneurs who could design a low flush toilet or a way to desalinize water. And so while I'm not an engineer, as an economist, a climate change, if we allow prices to reflect scarcity, and if climate change increases scarcity, that's actually the beginnings of finding solutions to these challenges, because there will be money to be made for those entrepreneurs who can come up with new products that economize on what climate change has made scarce. And what's exciting about what the Air Resources Board is doing with AB 32, I call it the green guinea pig. And California's, because of our income and our progressivism and our previous success with regulation, while the rest of the world is free riding and not trying to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions, California has stepped up with the ARB, the Air Resources Board, leading the way. And if we successfully can show that California can cost effectively reduce its greenhouse gas emissions, I think there'll be a guinea pig effect that other nations like China and India, once we have a good idea, that idea can be adopted everywhere. And this is how you reduce greenhouse gas emissions. The reason I'm optimistic about my son's California future is that ARB's AB 32 will be effective. We're simultaneously going to reduce our greenhouse gas emissions, and we're going to adapt to the climate change we've already unleashed. So it's both mitigation and adaptation simultaneously taking place.